Hey guys, this tutorial will show you how to send SMS messages from Excel using the Twilio API and VBA. You can find the download link to this workbook in the description box. You only need to input your account SID, authentication token, your Twilio number, as well as the receiver numbers and the corresponding text messages you would like to send. After clicking this button, VBA will send the text messages. In the status column, you will see if it was successfully sent or not. Please note that the Twilio SMS API is a paid service. I do not have any partnership or affiliate link with Twilio. The purpose of this video is to show you how to connect to their API using VBA. To get started, head over to your Twilio account. If you do not have an account yet, follow the steps on their website. Once done, you might want to sign up for a paid number. However, for the sake of this tutorial, I will use the free trial number. To get the trial number, click on the following button. Twilio will then suggest you a trial number. As a next step, I will copy the number and paste it into my worksheet. You want to make sure that you do not include the leading plus. After that, I will also copy and paste the account SID and authentication token to my worksheet. Ensure that you will use your own ID and token because I will revoke my credentials before uploading this video. Okay, now we can switch gears and write the VBA code. For this, go to the Developer tab. If the Developer tab is not visible for you, you can enable it under File, Options, Customize Ribbon, and then tick the box next to Developer. After that, shoot up the Visual Basic Editor. First things first, I will insert a new module. Optionally, you could also name the module. Next, I will create a new sub-procedure and name it SendSMS. As we will be sending a POST request, we need to establish a reference to the object library called Microsoft XML version 6.0. You can do this under Tools, References, and then search for that library. Once you have found it, tick the box next to it and click OK. Now that we have sorted this out, I will declare a variable for the workbook and for our worksheet. I will set the workbook to this workbook and the worksheet to sheet 1. Next, let us get the values for the authentication from the worksheet. First, the accounts ID, which is in cell C4. Next, the authentication token. And finally, the sender number. As you remember, we have entered the sender number without the leading plus because we will be sending the POST request as URL encoded. To include the plus in our POST request, I will concatenate %2b with the phone number. As I intend to send messages to all numbers I have listed down in column B, I will use a for loop to iterate over each row. Yet, first I will need to determine the last entry, so the last row in column B. We can do this as follows. I will do the same for the column D, where I want to return whether Twilio successfully sent the message to the receiver or not. Before coding out the for loop, I would like to clear our status cells. Because every time you run this macro, you want to remove the status from the previous one. This is also an excellent opportunity to check if everything is working so far. So, let me type a status manually in cell D9. Next, I will execute our code line by line. If you hover over the variables, you will see the corresponding values which are currently assigned to them. For instance, the last row in column D is 9. In that case, I will clear the content from cell range D9 to D9. After executing this line, we will see that the cell content has been cleared. Let us now move on to the for loop from row number 9 to the last row of column B. First, I will get the receiver number and the text message we want to send. Also here, I will add the percentage to B in front of the number. The following line of code will be a little technical, but we will essentially create a request using the Microsoft XML version 6.0 library. Then I will be concatenating the Twilio URL with our account SID. By the way, you can find this URL in the official Twilio documentation. Next, we can open our POST request with our credentials. There are different ways to construct the request header. In my case, I will be using URL encoded. Twilio expects the POST request in a specific format, including the sender and receiver number and our text message. I will concatenate this information in a string and save it in a variable called POSTData. Once I have my data, I can send the POST request. Optionally, we could also get back the response status and text. This information will help us with any debugging. In my case, I will construct a string with the response status and text. Finally, I would like to return this string, so our result, back to the worksheet in column D. Additionally, I will add the current date and time information. Okay, and that's all there is to it. To make sure that everything is working, I will execute our code line by line. Perhaps we would also like to let the user know once the macro went through all the rows. I will do this with a simple message box. Okay, back in the worksheet, we can see that Twilio returned the status code 400, which means there was an error. And fair enough, we will see in the status text that the number I have inputted is not a valid phone number. So let me go ahead and enter my phone number here. By the way, if you are also using the trial number from Twilio, you can only send SMS to registered phone numbers. You can add more numbers by navigating to phone numbers. Under verified caller IDs, you can add more numbers. I did that already, so I should be good to go. I just need to assign our VBA subprocedure to the button I have inserted earlier. After that, I will execute our code. Unlike before, I'm getting back the status code 201, which means that Twilio has received a valid API request to send an outbound SMS message. And indeed, on my phone, I have received the SMS. Okay guys, and that's it for this tutorial. As always, if you have any questions, please let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching and see you next time.